Hello guys, today let us learn about how we are going to declare a variable inside the data region and store the results or move the results from code region to end data regions. So we are moving from code to data region. So the results is going to be, the operations are going to be calculated inside the code region and the results is going to be pushed to the data region. So this is my code. So as usual, we are going to start with an area. This is my program name and I am specifying that it is an code, mean to say it is the set of instructions. Inside this we will be having some set of instructions, so entry. So later we are going to export this respective label into an execution section. So this one is, I am loading an address of num1. So I am loading an address of num1 to an r1. So here num1 is going to hold some content 4123, so that 4123 is going to be seated in one of the address. So that address value is going to be stored, so address value is going to be stored into r1 register. So later I am taking the content of that address location. So in this we will be having an address location. So here the content of the r1, mean to say the content of the address, mean to say the content present inside that address is going to be stored into an r3. So r3 is going to have the value stored in address pointed by r1 register. So later I am going to perform a simple addition task. So r3 is going to have the content 4123. So r2 is going to perform 4123 plus 1 and that result is going to be stored in r2. So later I am loading the address location of the result. So this one, address location of the result to the r4. So this r4 is going to be declared under an data region. You can see here. So this is data region and this is code region. And one thing you need to remember, that the file name provided for the code and the file name provided for the data should be different. The file names for data and code should be different or else it won't get invoked. So inside the data region I have been declared a variable called result and its data type is DCT. And I am forcing that value to the 0 because I am storing my new results over here. So after loading the address of this result, it is going to be loaded to the R4 register. So now my job is to push the result which is stored in an R2 to the content pointed by the R4 value. So here R2 is pushed to content of R4 register. So here content is going to hold the address of the variable called as in result, so that result have been stored in a data. So you can see this. So here we have been make use of both code and a data region. So this are all the primary steps for getting into the code. So load R1. So the address of this num1 is going to be stored in a register R1. So you can see this, what this address is going to be get holded of. So this address is going to hold of 4123. So later I am taking that content into an R3 register. So this content of R1 is going to hold 4123. So that is going to be pushed to an R3 register here. You can see 4123. So later you are going to perform a simple addition task 4123 plus 1. So 4123 plus 1 is going to be get added and it is going to be stored in an R2 register. You can see here. So it is going to be stored in R2 register. So later I am pushing this R2 to an address pointed by R4. So before pushing, so this address will be having 0. so it is not having any of the content here. So after executing this line, so the what all the content present in R2 is going to be pushed to this respective address location. So after executing this line, so 4124, so the content present in R2 is going to be pushed to this respective address. So this is going to happen by declaring the variable in code, by executing the operations in code region, and we are going to push that results to an data region. So mark my words here, the file names for data and code region should be different. So here I have used word and here I have used P02, it is the file names. If these both are same, so the compiler or the assembler, sorry, the assembler is going to get enters into a confusion state that from where this result should be acquired of. So now if you click on this, it is going to tell that it is acquiring from the function called as an P02. So P02 where this result is going to be get decided with. So thanks for watching this movie.